Today, let's discuss the self-learning module 5 for quarter 2. The music of Cordillera is quite similar to Mindoro in terms of functions and purpose. Both provinces use their music for communication with the spirits in rituals and worship, wedding, works, courtship, festive occasions, and lullabies. Palawan music is characterized by the imitation of sounds from nature and the environment, like the chirping of the birds, sounds of insects, and the sounds of the wind and rain. Their music imitates the sounds of animals.
Pailantigi. Ibon-ibon tang kuko. Pailantigi. Pailantigi.
The Bisayan music is highly Spanish influenced because they colonized the Philippines for a long time. They brought their culture and religion from Western practice. Spanish musicians introduced new styles of music, which also has Western musical traditions. From the Spanish word ronda means serenade. Rondalia, string ensemble originating from Spain, played with a pick or plectrum. Tultogan. It is a bamboo and drum ensemble used by the natives for communication. To produce sound of the body of the bamboos, they are being struck by sticks. Binanog, gong, drum, and wooden percussion ensemble used to accompany a dance movement imitating the flight of the hawk. The next slide is another example of Visayan song entitled Sipilimon. We are going to discuss the Mimaropa and the Visayan art internal and external art influence. Arts and crafts vary in their style, materials, and influence depending on their origins. For some arts and crafts in Mimaropa and Visayas province, we can see the different influences that manifested in them. Most of the arts and crafts in Mimaropa regions depict its local and indigenous influences. They maximize materials that can be found around them. Their design patterns and inspirations are usually representation of nature and the culture that they have in their area. While some of the arts and crafts and even in the architectures of the Visayas region have a touch of foreign influences of Spain, because the Spanish colonizer first landed in this region, and the locals embraced their culture. However, there are still some local traditions and influences that can be seen in some of their arts and crafts. The Molo Church in Iloilo depicts the fusion of Gothic and Renaissance styles, as you can see on the picture. The spires of the two towers of the church and the interior elements, such as the altar and the pulpits, show the Gothic characteristics of the church. This church is regarded as a woman's church because of the 16 women saints inside and its patron saint, which is Saint Anne. The church was constructed with white coral rocks. The Miag-au Church in Iloilo is an example of the Baroque Romanesque architecture that shows through its massive quality, thick walls, round arches, sturdy piers, groin vaults, large towers, and decorative arcades. It is famous for its artistic sculptural relief curve in the facade of the church that illustrates the way of life of the people of Miag-au. It is acclaimed as a UNESCO World Heritage Site. The ruins found in Talisay Negros Occidental is an example of neoclassical architecture. It was built by a wealthy hacendero for his Portuguese wife in the early 1900s. It was destroyed by fire during the World War II, leaving behind the concrete structure that stands to this day. The colors of the ruins change from white to gray and orange to red as the sunset touches the structure, as you can see on the picture. In PE, we are going to discuss the table tennis basic stance and footwork. Footwork in table tennis is not entirely automated. Players, both amateur and professionals, were not used technically perfect footwork during a rally. Things are not that simple for the opponent trying to put a ball into awkward locations if stances and footwork develop correctly. For the ready position, feet should be slightly further apart than shoulder width to have a solid base, as you can see on the picture. The pre-arm is used for balance with your shoulders forward. Weight should be on the toes. Racket needs to be in a neutral position to play, whether a backhand or a forehand stroke. In table tennis, good footwork is essential for it enables players to quickly reach the ball, return the ball to the opponent's court, put pressure on the opponent, and more significantly, play a variety of strokes.
Hi, I'm Alois Rosero from Ping Skills.
And I'm Jeff Plum, and today we're going to talk about basic footwork.
In table tennis, most of your movement is sideways, so it's really important to get that movement correct. Some basic things that you need to think about are making sure that you're down nice and low in your basic ready position. Once you're in that ready position, it's a matter of moving sideways with either a little bit of a jump or a shuffle. The easiest way to learn the basic footwork is to do it nice and slowly and one ball at a time. So I'm going to feed the ball out one at a time to Jeff. So we start with hit, jump, hit, jump into position and hit. And I'm catching the ball each time to give Jeff plenty of time to get the movement correct. Once you feel like your movement's correct, then you can start to hit the ball continuously. So it's a hit and jump, hit and jump, hit and jump, hit and jump, hit and jump.
During a rally in table tennis, most often you have to move sideways. Side-to-side footwork is moving to the left and right with a quick side-to-side shuffling steps. There are many times when you have to cover a wider area for returning a ball. At that time, your side-to-side footwork is not enough. Crossover footwork is useful in this moment to cover a large distance quickly. This is an example of in and out footwork pattern in table tennis. When you face a short service, you have to move your body to come closer to the ball and after making the stroke, return to your ready position. One step footwork is performed by stepping toward the ball with the closest foot. This is useful when the ball is slightly out of reach, so you can use one of your foot to reach near the ball and after the stroke. It comes back to the ready position. The advantage of this footwork is the better body balance as your shoulder and body don't move too much.
When positioning yourself in table tennis, it's best to stay square onto the table most of the time. Even when you have to move side to side, it's best to remain facing the table. But there is always that really wide ball that you're going to struggle to reach by just moving sideways because that just isn't a fast enough movement. In that situation, what we need to do is implement the crossover footwork. The crossover footwork is used when the ball is really wide and you're not going to be able to move fast enough sideways. It's basically a running motion. So we're starting in that facing the table position, but now suddenly we see that that ball has come out way too wide for us. And what we do is we lift our left leg into a running motion and we do that to make the ground, to make the shot. While you're moving across, you also need to get your bat back and prepared to play the stroke. If you run across and then try and play the stroke, you're not going to have enough momentum and power. Let's have a look at this preparation part. As you're moving across, your bat's going back, but your body is also twisting so that you're coiled and ready to play your shot. When do you make contact with the ball? As your foot is landing on the ground is the best time to make contact. So it's now.
For Health Week 5, we are going to discuss how to address malnutrition in our country. In the Philippines, there are several government programs, projects, and campaigns to address the problems of malnutrition and micronutrients deficiencies, such as Sangkap Pinoy, Pinggang Pinoy, and the 10 Commandments. The Philippine Food Fortification Act of 2000 or RA 8976 seeks to address the micronutrient deficiencies in our country. It urges manufacturers of processed food to fortify their products under the Sangkap Pinoy program that will supplement the inadequate diet of the ordinary people. The Department of Social Welfare and Development, or DSWD, in cooperation with the Department of Education, or DepEd, is conducting feeding programs for malnourished children in public schools all over the country. The Department of Science and Technology, or DOST, also helps in government campaigns by disseminating nutrition information and technology. The Food and Nutrition Research Institute, or FNRI, introduced the Pinggang Pinoy, which promotes a balanced diet by showing the recommended proportions of rice, vegetables, protein source foods, and fish per meal basis. Salt Iodization Act, or ASIN, or also known as RA 8172, requires the addition of iodine to all salt intended for animal and human consumption to eliminate micronutrient and malnutrition in our country. The 10 Commandments is a campaign to promote the Nutritional Guidelines for Filipinos, or NGF, by the National Nutrition Council, or NNC, of the Department of Health, DOH, which are simple and easy to remember nutritional guidelines to address and prevent malnutrition and diet-related non-communicable diseases such as cancer, diabetes, and cardiovascular diseases. Other than the mentioned government programs, projects, and campaigns to address malnutrition and micronutrient deficiencies in the country, the best way to prevent malnutrition is to eat a healthy, balanced diet and live a healthy lifestyle. Let's discuss the activities for your module. These are the activities for your music week 5. We have activity 1, sing it, post it, and activity 2, action sounds better. Just follow the directions written on your module and your score will be rated according to the rubrics. For your art activity in week 5, you are going to analyze the picture on your module and trace the influence that you can see based on the materials and characteristics of the design used. After that, you are going to explain how you came up with your answers. These are the physical education activities for week 5. We have activity 1, basic footwork drills 1, and activity 2, footwork drills 2. You are going to perform the following movement: side-to-side footwork, in-and-out footwork, and crossover footwork, and evaluate performance based on the rubrics. You may take a picture or record your performance of the 3 different footwork. For health activity, we have activity 1. Choose only one activity, either slogan, poster, or infographics on how to prevent and control malnutrition and micronutrient deficiencies. For activity 2, you are going to choose only one activity, either portfolio or 5 to 10 minutes video presentation. Follow the instructions written on your module and you will be rated according to the rubrics.